Okay, so we are solving web assigned chapter 2, problem 6, which is the problem 28 from Giancarlo's book 6th edition. So what we have here is a car that is moving, and it's moving in my case. This car is moving with 91 kilometers per hour, so constant speed. And after 2 seconds, this person will slow down. So you see, the person realizes that she has to slow down, but it takes 2 seconds for her to finally press the brake. So this is what is called human reaction time. So during this whole 2 seconds, during this whole time interval, the car keeps moving with a constant speed because she has not pressed the brake yet. Okay? And then finally she will press the brake, so we'll have an acceleration, which is given there for us, 4 meters per second square. I'm assuming here the positive is to the right, so this acceleration is minus 4 meters per second square, so that I can slow down, and then finally the car will stop. We'll have here V0. Okay. So what we want to know is the total distance that this car traveled until it finally reached this point where it stopped. Okay. So during this whole 2 seconds, it kept moving with constant speed. So to find this displacement here, which I'll call delta x1, I just have to use the equation for average velocity, which is delta x1 here divided by delta t. So the average velocity here is 91 kilometers per hour. The delta t is 2 seconds, careful with the units, and then we will get this delta x1. Then I'll call here this part this delta x2, in which the car finally started slowing down. So how am I going to find this total distance? Well, since they give us no information about time, the best equation is to use v squared is equal to v naught squared plus 2a delta x2. V final is 0 because we finally stopped. V initial is that 91 kilometers per hour because we up to that point we had not slowed down. The acceleration is that minus 4 meters per second squared, and then we'll find delta x. So the total distance traveled will be delta x1 plus delta x2. Again, be very careful with the units. Be consistent.